Hello, I'm Dr. Amignon. I work in CHU Charleroi, Belgium, and I'm an interventional cardiologist. So we in our center use transradial access in more than 90% of our patients. The transradial access, as you know, is becoming more and more popular around the world because of many advantages such as reduced access seat complication and also reduced access seat bleeding. But there is a drawback of the radial intervention, which is radial occlusion. And there are several strategies to avoid or to prevent radial occlusion, which are good heparinization and good level of anticoagulation in every patient. The fact to use the smallest sheath available to complete the procedure, and this is very important, and we now have the slender sheath from Terumo, which have reduced outer diameter. But last but not least, it's very important to achieve in every patient what we call a patent hemostasis. And this has been shown in a study in 2008 by Samir Pancheri, that the fact that you use a patent hemostasis as compared to traditional hemostasis protocol decreases significantly the rate of radial occlusion. In the following video, I will show you how to perform a patent hemostasis of the radial artery. So this patient was randomized into the glide sheet slender 6-French group. And now we are going to remove the introducer sheet. So what do you need to perform a patent hemostasis protocol? You need, of course, a tear band, which is here. And you need also a plethysmography with the assessment of the arterial pulse, which is very important to assess the non-occlusive compression of the radial artery. So first of all, as usual, you place the tear band about, on average, 1 centimeter above the puncture seat, as you can see here. And we first inflate the tear band with 12 cc of air, as shown here. It could be less, it depends from hospitals to other hospitals. Okay. That is done. Then we remove the introducer and we check if there are any bleeding. And any, so you see here that the removal is very smooth and without pain, so there are no spasms in the radial artery. Okay. So now we have, of course, a pulse on the plethysmography, but it's impossible to state if we have an occlusive compression of the radial artery. Then we have to compress, as you can see here, the ulnar artery. We do it here. And you see that we have a loss of the arterial pulse, or at least a flattening of the curve, which means that the compression is occlusive. So what we have to do now is to remove some air of the tear band.
2 cc.
2 cc. And we are going to check again if the compression is occlusive at the level of the radial artery. Of course, you must not have bleeding at the puncture site, which is very important also. Here you see that the small curve is reappearing here on the plethysmograph. Okay, so that means that the radial artery now it's open. But what we are going to do, in every patient we try to achieve the lowest pressure achievable to get the artery open without bleeding. So we will try to remove 1 cc more of air.
I think we can't remove any cc because the hip.
Okay, here we have some bleeding. We will try anyway just to show 1 cc of air more, just to see.
We have cc.
Okay, 1 cc more. Okay. Then again, we try to compress the ulnar artery. Okay, here we have bleeding. So we have to. Okay, we have to put again 1 cc of air because then we have bleeding. This is the balance between the bleeding at the level of the artery and the fact that you want to achieve a patent hemostasis, which is not always achievable. So,
but you have a good result.
But did you put again 1 cc of air? Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Yes, I put.
Okay, we have put 1 cc more of air.
Okay, we have a curve. We have a curve, so we have a patent hemostasis. We have achieved patent hemostasis, which means that we have a non-occlusive compression of the radial artery, as you can see here, so it's okay. And we don't have an active bleeding at the puncture site, so it's okay. We have achieved patent hemostasis, and you see that it's not always easy. You have sometimes to remove some air, to add some air, because there's the balance between bleeding at the level of puncture site and the fact that you want to achieve patent hemostasis in every patient. So thank you very much, and see you later.